Good morning, good morning, good morning. How are we doing today? I'm Evangelist Sophia Jeffrey here from Wise Choice Ministries. And this morning is our time of prayer. I thank you for stopping by and coming in this morning. If you have any prayer requests, please submit them on in the comments below or inbox us after the broadcast. And whatever I don't see while I'm praying this morning, I will definitely go back and pray for those prayers that are ones that are submitted. Good morning, Sister Crystal. Thank you for coming on. This morning I'm going to give a little scripture, a couple of scriptures that God laid on my heart for this morning. And I'm actually coming from the book of Ephesians. We are in the book of Ephesians chapter 6, and I'm going to start at that 10th verse, and it talks about the whole armor of God, putting on the armor of God. And again, I'm coming from the book of Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 10. And again, good morning. Thank you for coming by and logging in, trying to wait a couple of seconds and then before I start reading the word. But if book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 10, and the word of God, and I'm reading from the New King James Version, the word of God says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against the principalities, against the powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, and against spiritual wickedness in heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all to stand. Verse 14, stand therefore, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God." Then verse 18, "Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints." Thus ends the reading of the word. Again, that was Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10. And I want to look at the significance of verse 10. It says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might." In his might. My question for you this morning, before I start praying, whose might are you standing in? Whose might are you standing in? Right now, people are going through different situations and different times. And the purpose of the enemy is to put us in tests and trials to steal our faith. And when you go through so many tests and trials over and over and over again without any type of release, relief, that test and trial can sometimes get you off balance and can cause you to start questioning God and get you weary and tired. But when we do like verse 10 says, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might, a lot of times we're trying to do it in our own might. We're trying to do it in our own strength. And our strength cannot compare or do anything with the strength of the enemy, which is the devil. But the strength of the Lord can do whatever we need to do. This month, we're talking about strongholds, and a lot of us, a lot of society has some type of stronghold. But when we put on the whole arm of God and stand in his might and not ours, and use this sword that he's given us with the word, we can break that stronghold over our life. It's a casting down imaginations against every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. So when God has already given us the blueprint of how to break strongholds, how to overcome the works of the devil, how to stand strong in him, we just have to do it. So I wanted to encourage you this morning as to say, don't try and stand in your own strength. Try and stand, not try. Stand in the strength of God. Get in the word, read the word, come in alignment with the word, agree the word. He said, put on the whole arm of God. Put on that the arm of God so he can strengthen you and you can stand in his might and not yours. And watch God give us the victory. We have to remember that the battle is the Lord's and the victory is ours. It's already done. It was finished on Calvary. Over 2,000 years ago, we already have the victory. God has given it to us. So we just have to stand firm. He said, it says, stand strong. Therefore, he says in verse 13, therefore, take up the whole arm of God that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all to stand, then verse 14, stand therefore. When you done did everything you can do, just stand in his might. Just stand. Praise him. Worship him. Honor him. Don't complain. Praise him. Read the word. Thank him for his strength. His strength is your strength. His joy is your joy. His peace is your peace. You have to fight that weapon with the words of your mouth. Revelations tell us that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. So my question again is, what is your testimony? Is your testimony is I'm failing, I'm falling, I can't do it? Or is your testimony is I have already overcome? We're overcoming. See, some people are struggling, but God says enter his rest so you can rest in him. He's telling us how to thrive. We should be thriving. We are reigning as kings in life because we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. So I just wanted to encourage you today that the victory is already won. The devil is defeated. God is exalted. And Jesus is Lord, and nothing can ever change that. So we already have the victory in Christ Jesus. We just have to stand in it and walk it out in him by faith. So I'm going to start this prayer this morning. And if you have any prayer requests, please submit them on the line. And if I don't see them before I finish praying, I will come back this morning and pray for you. And again, if you want to inbox us at Wise Choice, please do. Or if you want to inbox me, I'll be glad to reach the throne of grace for you on today. So, yes, we are overcomers in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, I come this morning, Lord Jesus, boldly upon the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Father God, we are strong in the power of his might. We put on the whole arm of God that we may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against the principalities. We wrestle against the powers. We wrestle against the rulers of darkness of this world. And we wrestle against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, we take unto me the whole arm of God that we may be able to stand in the evil day. And having done all to stand, having done all to overcome, I overcome, we overcome in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we just thank you, Lord, that we are already overcomer. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. And our testimony is that we are overcomers. Father, you tell us to walk by faith and not by sight. So, Father, regardless of what it looks like, regardless of what it feels like, regardless of what it may seem to be coming up against us, Father God, we have overcome it, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, you said in your word, no weapon formed against us shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise up against us in judgment, we will condemn. For this is the heritage of the servant of the Lord, and our righteousness is of him, saith the Lord. For we are like a tree that's planted by the rivers of water in the name of Jesus. So God, we thank you, Lord, that even if the weapon forms, Lord, it's not going to prosper, Lord. What the devil meant for evil, Father God, God has worked it out for our good. So Father God, we, like we say, we are overcomers, Father, because you already given us the victory, Lord. And we just thank you, Lord, that we have the victory in Christ Jesus. Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for being a God that's all by yourself, Lord, for being all powerful, all knowing, and all seeing, God. Father God, we thank you, Lord, that we have a right to use the name of Jesus, because the name of Jesus is above every name. And Father God, no matter what it is, Father God, no matter what's the title it is, Lord, that it has to bow down to the name of Jesus. Father God, even if it has not been created yet, it has to submit to the name of Jesus. So, Father God, we thank you for the use of the name of Jesus, that we have a right and a privilege to use the name of Jesus. And, Lord, we just thank you, Lord. I plead the blood of Jesus over every viewer, Lord, over everyone that's assigned and attached to Wise Choice Ministries, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I plead the blood of Jesus over our families and our household, Lord, that everyone that comes in line online today, Lord, that listen to this prayer, Lord, will be healed, delivered, and set free, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, have your way, Lord. God, you are an awesome God, and you're a mighty God, and you're a wonderful God. And Lord, we just say thank you, Lord. Yes to your will, Father God, and yes to your way, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, you will keep us. Your word says, Father God, you will keep us in perfect peace, whose mind and inclination is stayed on thee, Father God, because we trust in you. Lord, we trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and we lean not to our own understanding, Father God. In all our ways, we can acknowledge you because you have directed our path. Father God, when we stand strong in you and keep our mind on you, Lord, we don't have to think about the attacks of the enemy because he's already defeated. Jesus defeated Satan when he was on Calvary. He defeated death when he went into the grave and came up 3 days later. So we already have the victory. We just have to stand in his might and the power of the Lord's might. And Lord, and walk this victory out, Lord. And Father God, we thank you, Lord, that we can walk in your might, Father God. It's not by power nor by might, but by my spirit, the Holy Spirit that strengthens us, Father God, in our inner man, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, have your way, Lord. And we just thank you, Father God. Father God, we're praying right now for families that are going through bereavement, Lord. Families that are hurting right now, Lord. We know, Father God, that you are the God of comfort. You comfort us all, Lord. And we ask, Lord, that you comfort those that are mourning, Lord. We pray that you comfort those that have suffered loss, Lord, that are in need of your healing, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for the Jones family, Lord, for the loss of their sister, Father God, that you mend their brokenness, Father God, that you mend their hearts and mind, Lord, and help them to keep their mind stayed on you, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, I pray for the Choice and the Brown family, Lord, that you continue to strengthen them, Father God, as they walk through this darkness, Lord, this dark season, and continue to look to you, Father God, who is the light, Father God. I pray for the Washington and Davis family, Lord, again, they're suffering bereavement and need your strength, Lord. And Lord, for the Tony Robinson and Brooks family, Lord, the Nelson family, the Dukes and Robinson family, Lord, continue to strengthen them, Father God, and mend their brokenness, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we look to you, Lord, to give them all a new normal. Lord, when someone passes away, the rest of the people in the world can just go on with their normal lives, Lord, but the ones that are in the family, Lord, they are shattered and broken, Lord. So I ask, Father God, that you give them a new normal to allow them, Lord, to take one step forward, Lord, to try and get their life back into some form of normality, Lord. Help them, Father God, in a mighty way, Lord. And we just look to you, Father God. God, you are an awesome God and you're a mighty God. Lord, you are a comforter, Lord. You are a heal. You are a strength and our deliverer, Father God. You are a healer, Lord. Father God, I pray for those who are sick, Lord. Lord, I plead the blood of Jesus over them, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, you said in your word in Psalms 106, 107 and 20, that you sent your word to heal them and deliver them from destruction. So I'm sending the word. I'm sending Jesus because Jesus is the word to heal their body, Lord, to mend their broken them, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And I speak healing and life over them right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And God, have your way, Lord. Lord, you are an awesome God. You are a mighty God. And Lord, that anybody that's coming up against, sickness is coming up against them right now, I rebuke it right now in the name of Jesus. I rebuke the spirit of death, sickness, and illness that's coming up against people right now in the name of Jesus. God, have your way, God. God, you are an awesome God, and you are a mighty God. You are a healer. And you are our strength, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And Father, I pray, Lord, for this nation, Lord. I thank you, first of all, Lord, that things are settling down somewhat, Father God, but we still need more of your presence, Father God. We thank you, Lord, for your healing, Lord. We speak healing over this nation continuously, Father God, in the name of Jesus. God, have your way, Lord. Lord, this nation still needs healing. This nation needs transformation, Father God. This nation still needs to bring you back into our government, into our families, into our home, into our society, in the name of Jesus. God, we invoke your presence throughout this nation, Lord, so that true transformation and healing can take place of the hearts and minds of the people, Father God. Lord, we curse the spirit of the Antichrist and the works of the devil, Father God, that's coming up against this nation, this government, the House of Representatives and the Senate, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father, you said in your word that the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the work of the devil. And anything that's coming up against your kingdom being brought to this earth is the work of the devil, and it's destroyed in Jesus' name. So, Father God, I lift up the president, Lord, Joe Biden, and his vice president, Lord, Ms. Harris, Lord, that you bring them under divine alignment with you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. That you keep a hedge of protection around them and keep them safe from all hurt, harm, and danger, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father, give them wisdom and spiritual insight, Lord, on what to do, Lord, on what decisions to make, Father God. And Lord, keep them in your hands, Father God. Bring each party together, Lord, so that we can be on one accord for this nation, Lord, so that we can look to you for directions, Father God, in the name of Jesus. God, have your way, God. God, you are an awesome God and you're a mighty God and you are a wonderful God. And Lord, we just thank you, Father God, and we just praise you, Lord. And Lord, we thank you, Lord, for being God all by yourself. We thank you, Father God, that you are a healer, that you are a deliverer, Father God, and you are a sustainer, Father God. And Lord, I just say thank you. God, have your way, Lord. Have your way, God, because you are Father. You are Father God. And Lord, we just praise you, God. You're worthy to be praised, Father God. And Lord, we just thank you, Father. And Father, when you do this prayer, Lord, when you answer these prayers, Father God, we'll be so careful and grateful, Father God, to give you all the praise and to give you all the glory. Father God, we ask this prayer and these blessings, Father God, in the matchless and the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray, Father God. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. So again, if there's any prayer requests, please submit them on the line. And I'll definitely come back to them after I get off the broadcast. And I thank you again for stopping by and for this morning prayer. Tonight, this evening at 7 p.m., I will be teaching a Bible study lesson tonight on overcoming strongholds, because that's our series for the month of March, Overcoming Strongholds. And tonight I'll be teaching on overcoming the stronghold of carnality. Christians acting like non-believers. So tonight is the Bible study at 7 p.m. So please join us on this this page, WCM, at 7 p.m. For Bible study tonight. So I thank you for stopping by, and I pray that you are blessed and have a blessed day, and that we continue to stand strong in Jesus's might, in the Lord's might, and not in ours, and allow him to work things out for our good and his glory. So again, thank you for stopping by. I'm Evangelist Sophia Jeffrey from Wise Choice Ministries, and you continue to be blessed.